FebriDx is a 10-minute disposable rapid point-of-care test with one finger stick of blood. You're looking at two biomarkers. Basically, the best way to put that is that we are looking to differentiate between viral and bacterial infection.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Paul Kase. He's the Senior Vice President with Lumos Diagnostics. And Paul, it's good to see you again. How are you?
I'm excellent, Steve. Thanks so much for having me.
Yeah, so the company has some pretty significant news, and we'll talk about that in just a second, but all based around FebriDx. So maybe you can talk a bit about this so everyone kind of understands what we're talking about this news.
Well, happy to, Steve. Happy to. So FebriDx is a 10-minute disposable rapid point-of-care test with one finger stick of blood. You're looking at two biomarkers. Basically, the best way to put that is that we are looking to differentiate between viral and bacterial infection. And so done with, again, a test that's reimbursed. It's done at the point of care and helps at a 99% negative predictive value to help physicians as a tool to determine whether a patient needs an antibiotic or not.
Yeah. And as we've seen in lots of studies to show that sometimes antibiotics are overprescribed. So this in order gives you some peace of mind, I guess, when you're going forward and quickly.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Many folks look at antigen testing where you're ruling in a particular infection. So you're diagnosing whether it's an influenza or COVID, where with FebriDx, you're actually looking at giving the doctor a tool to say, do I need to make a prescription or not? And it's very novel, and we're really excited about it.
Yeah, so which brings us to the news, and that is that you've partnered with WellStreet Urgent Care in order to for reimbursements in the United States. So tell me a bit about this company and how this is going to work.
We're really excited about it. Really excited about it. So WellStreet has raised their hand to us and said, "Hey, we believe in this. We believe it's scalable." And I think scalable is the key word here, Steve, because they are going to start with one site. It's a joint venture with Piedmont in Fayetteville, Georgia, and then. In a way, looking at it, saying, "Hey, let's make sure the clinical workflow makes sense. Let's look into reimbursement. We're going to help you with claims." And then at that point, the intention would be with the CLIA waiver grant from the FDA to spread it to all 140 sites. So it's a large urgent care chain, and we're excited to partner in ways of one, just looking through to make sure clinically it flows through their process, and at the same time make sure that we are gathering information that we need to once CLIA waiver is granted.
Yeah. Paul, is it a case where you are able to, you know, use the WellStreet Urgent Care to, as you mentioned, 140 areas across the United States? You have to take that first sort of step in and that wide distribution across the US. And that is quite wide at 140 locations. Is that part of the overall growth strategy in order to get this everywhere in the US?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So there's say, even in the urgent care market size, there's 20 organizations that represent quite a bit of the entire 11,000 urgent care sites. So we're looking at partners such as WellStreet to be able to, one, help us to spread the word, right? The education, the awareness, and then we create advocacy along the way. And so, yes, it's key to our growth strategy as we look at not just the urgent care market, the primary care market, the retail health market, the list goes on and on. But we're real excited to be able to at least be able to establish our footprint in the urgent care space with WellStreet.
And you mentioned it's going to start in Atlanta, Georgia. So is that imminent or in 2026? What are the timelines here?
I've just started. Actually, they're testing as we speak. We're really excited.
Perfect.
Right. So testing, submitting claims. Again, FebriDx is reimbursed under what they call a PLA code in the U.S. At $41.38. And so we are just thrilled that they've taken the first step, again, with the intention to scale it throughout the entire organization.
Well, congratulations. Great start. And I look forward to continuing to follow the story as always. Paul, thanks so much. Good to see you again.
Can't thank you enough, Steve. Thanks so much.
All right. There's Paul Kase, Senior Vice President of Lumos Diagnostics.